Hey you guys, Phoebe here from Little Grey Box with Matt behind the camera. Today we are on tour with the guys at Intrepid Travel and Travel South because we are exploring the southern USA states of Tennessee, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Georgia. And today we are exploring Savannah, Georgia. To help you travel well, we are going to be sharing all of our experiences as we spend 24 incredible hours here in Savannah, Georgia. If you don't already, be sure to subscribe right now and give us a hello in the comments back. Now, in our first video of this series, we explored Nashville, and in the second, we visited Asheville and Charleston. If you haven't seen those, go and watch them now and then come back here so you are all caught up. Located in the historic district of Savannah, Forsyth Park covers an area of around 30 acres. And you can wander below ancient oak trees that are lush and green and dripping in moss. Having just seen her, it seems appropriate to have lunch at Paula Deen's restaurant, The Lady and Sons. Now, Paula Deen's restaurant actually started out as a lunch service, a brown bag business. Her and her sons would make lunches and they would deliver them to Savannah locals. The menu here is a celebration of Southern cooking and soul food, and I am so excited to get in there and give it a try. I really like it. It's interesting to come and try something different. I have a feeling maybe people are going to roast us and be like, you came all the way to Savannah and you want to try soul food and go to Paula Deen's? I'm sure there's some amazing restaurants cooking fantastic soul food, but I have gone for lots of salad, lots of hot sauce. Great experience.
I don't know if I think this is the best presentation that I've ever seen of peach cobbler. Yeah. But I'm going to try it. So here we go, I'm gonna shut up.
Is it good?
It's good. The shade that I put on it for presentation is actually unwarranted because it tastes friggin' delicious.
At the Bonaventure Cemetery, did I say that right?
Yeah, Bonaventure Cemetery.
And Michaela's gonna tell us a little bit about it.
So back in the day, there's this famous Scottish-American naturalist named John Muir. He is well known for his work with the Sierra Club and for his work in establishing our national park system. He's the person that really fought to get Yosemite protected, which was the first public land that was preserved solely for the sake of preservation and recreation. And when he was coming through the South, he came through this cemetery and thought it was just like the most beautiful place in the South, and he decided that this would be a good place for a lonely traveler to spend his nights while exploring the area. And so he slept on the gravestones while he was living in the South and just spent his days wandering around this area.
And if you don't know the name John Muir, you might know the quote.
If the mountains are calling and I must go.
So I didn't know the name, but as soon as I heard the quote, it clicked in my mind.
Yeah.
But this cemetery is incredible. It's absolutely huge. They're big oak trees, right? Dripping with all that
oak
moss.
Oak trees, magnolias. Yeah.
Incredible. Just checked into our room here at the Holiday Inn, and our room here is gorgeous. So we've literally just walked in the door and it looks amazing. This bathroom is a fantastic size, plenty of bench space, big shower, toilet of course. Then through here we've got a really good sized room, not too big, not too small. Everywhere we've stayed we've had two beds, which is interesting. Share a bed, use one for luggage, take a bed each. your choice. We've got a little workspace, microwave, little kitchenette area. We are just a couple of minutes walk from all the major tourist sites, the downtown area, so it is really accessible. And I believe I had a little bit of a look on the internet. It looks to be very well priced as well. Is there a heaven, there a hell? You know where I take it and you know I do it well. When I come through, better show up with respect. I ain't want nothing but that check. You can catch me at your door, you can catch me in your home. Oh, you're running late, just send the address to my phone. Copy, paste, and go. So Leopold's, the famous ice cream store here in Savannah, was founded in 1919 by three brothers, and they are famous for their soda jerks. They make their ice cream, all of their toppings in-house. We just lined up, it was a bit of a lineup to get in there, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be worth it. It's so good. It's sweet, but it's also nice and tangy too. Oh wow, you can try, but you'll never get by, baby. Oh wow, oh wow, they try, but they'll never get by, baby. Oh wow, oh wow. Now we are doing a bit of a stroll along the riverside here on the historic River Street. There are some really interesting spots set up, just talking about the area's history of slavery, which were really great to read for us. And then as you walk down further here, there are so many pubs lining the area, and owing to its great seaside location, I hear the seafood is meant to be amazing too. Anything goes, but don't go with me. If you hear
talk, stay silent to eat. Are you ready to see? Guys, we have come to a little place called Pounce, which is a cat cafe and wine bar, a combination of the two best things on earth. And don't worry if you're not a wine drinker, they do beer too. Now, all the cats that you see here, they are rescues, and not only that, but they are also up for adoption. And you guys, it is hands down the best cat cafe I have ever come to. Why you came? When it comes to the pain, don't you stray.
This book is How to Talk to Your Cat About Gun Safety and Abstinence, Drugs, Satanism, and Other Dangers That Threaten Their Nine Lives. Compared to all the other cats, she doesn't seem on the same level. They've been quite docile and friendly until this point.
And look at the empathy coming from there.
Oh, she's getting closer. I think she's got to breathe.
Now there is no shortage of amazing restaurants here in Savannah, but we have come to a little place called The Fox and Fig, and it is a plant-based restaurant, so you know I am incredibly excited.
I have got a plant-based mac and cheese. It is smoky, mushroomy, my mouth is watering.
Now we've really just scratched the surface of Savannah. We have had the best time. Our tour guide Michaela has been unbelievable. She is just phenomenal. She's gone above and beyond for us, taken such good care of us, and made our trip that much more special. So thank you to Michaela, thank you to Team Intrepid, and thank you to Travel South. That brings this video to a close. I really hope you have enjoyed it. Now, if you don't already, be sure to subscribe and say hello in the comments below. Have a great weekend, and I will see you next week. Love you.